Hello, my name is Cristina Silva from Motic Europe, and today I would like to present you our first scanner for pathology applications, the Motic EasyScan system. The Motic EasyScan is the perfect solution to convert your classical glass slides into high-resolution digital data on a simply one-click procedure. These days, the use of digital slide versions is the best approach to offer reliable, fast and efficient work in medical environments, but also for universities in teaching purposes. With the Motic EasyScan system, you can digitalize your samples on just a click, and you can further store the information locally on your computer, you can send it by email, or you can upload the scanned images on a cloud server. You can also use the conference function, which allows a network remote sharing and viewing for group discussions and education. Motic is currently offering two versions of this system, the Motic EasyScan and the Motic EasyScan Pro. Both of them integrate a 20x apochromatic objective with a numerical aperture of 0.75. The two versions allow bright field scanning until 40x magnification of one slide in the case of Motic EasyScan or 6 slides in the case of Motic EasyScan Pro. Together with the apochromatic objective, a fast-speed CCD camera and a high-speed autofocus feature allows the system to deliver fast and reliable images. For example, the scanning time of an area of 15x15mm is about 3 to 4 minutes at 40x magnification on a normal scanning quality. The complete system includes the scanner itself, two software, a PC with Intel quad-core processor and a high-definition LED monitor with 24-inch. The two software are the Motic EasyScanner, which is used to calibrate the system and to control the scanning parameters, and the Motic DS Assistant. The Motic DS Assistant is an image viewer with other thing functions to control image processing, adjustments and enhancements. It also includes the conference function for network remote sharing. Please make sure you contact your Motic sales representative to find out your package selection, because different territories may offer different package options. The scanning process is really easy. Just take the tray, place your slides on the tray, and load the tray on the scanner. Make sure that the white dot is aligned with the arrow mark and just initiate the Motic EasyScanner software. Although we can define by default the scanning settings, it is always possible to customize the conditions for each individual position. For each slide, we can select the magnification and the scanning mode. We can choose between four alternative scanning modes. The first option is the normal scanning mode. On this case, the system detects the focal plane on each field and captures the image. Then we have the high scanning mode. In this mode, the optics goes through several focal planes on each field, but selects the one with more information. Then we have EDF, extension depth of field. On this option, the system goes through several focal planes as previously, but in this case, the different captures are combined on a unique image. Finally, we have the Z-Stack mode. This mode uses several focal planes as well, but in this case, no further combination occurs, which means that we will have a digital file that will give us image information about the different layers. Once we have decided the scanning condition for each slide, we can initiate the process just pressing scan. The scanning area is automatically selected, which means that the area within the slide containing the tissue is detected and bordered. Moreover, the blank areas are identified and discarded in order to shorten the scanning time. Nevertheless, a manual edition is always possible to customize each one of the slides. I can also add some regions to my previous selection, or I can remove a part of the selected region. On the settings window, The advanced settings are available through a password control. Here we can change the calibration in order to customize the different parameters of the system, like for instance the exposure, white balance, background, etc. Once the scanning process is completed, we can have a first access to the digital image directly on this software, using this image browser included on the software. The scanning process originates images which are available on a digital format through the DS Assistant software. The software includes a slide database where all the information is stored on a library, where each file is presented under the .ds format, which means digital slide format. The DS format is in fact an interactive information package which saves the information from the sample and links it with a barcode, with a slide map, as well as with any kind of attached documents. For instance, you can add a PDF document, you can add a JPEG image, any kind of report in a Word format, Excel format, etc. So the software includes two main tabs, the library and the tab for slide edition. On the library, you have a thumbnail slide viewer, plus a detailed list where you have the information of each one of the files, like the magnification, the image size, resolution, etc. If you click on one of the files, you immediately go to the slide edition tab. So here you have the slide thumbnail, you have the information for the barcode. On this menu, you can activate or deactivate different tools like the zoomer, the scale bar, grind, etc. And obviously, you can zoom in and out on your image. If you need to screen the sample, just double-click on the keyboard arrow keys in order to have a smooth movement on the four directions. To stop on the region of interest, just make a simple click. On the ZStack files, the user has obviously the option to navigate to the different layers of the image. For instance, if I now change the area, I can go through the different layers in order to find the focus for this position. The DS Assistant software also allows the user to highlight reference areas on the image using the different tools available. For instance, if I want to highlight this area, I can use the record position tool here. There is also several measuring tools available, which I can use to measure, let's say, this structure over here. I can also introduce a text note or an audio record. All these tools create an annotation list, which I can activate here. And as you can see, each one of the annotations is linked with the information about the position and magnification. The annotations are editable and the user can decide to make them visible or invisible on the image as well as the measurements. Comparison between multiple digital slides is another interesting tool on this software. In fact, this option can be extremely useful, for instance, when the comparison of similar sections with different stainings are required, or when similar sections from the same patient have to be contrasted from time to time. Synchronization of the images can facilitate their comparison, but can also be something useful to make the image processing easier. If you want to visualize more than one image on the screen, just use one of the split options. Once you have the different images on the screen, you can decide to use one of the synchronization options. The first one is the fast synchronization, which synchronizes the images according to their current position. Moreover, there is another option, which is full synchronization. In this case, the synchronization is done according to the XY position of the images. This software allows the user to share the images as well as to export them in different formats. In fact, we can choose between export the whole image or just parts of it. So we can either export as a first option the DS file, which means that we will be exporting the complete digital package, meaning exporting the interactive image plus any additional information like the annotations, measures, or any edit file. The new file will be compatible with DS Assistant or DS Assistant Lite version. The Lite version is available for free download from the Motic websites. As a second option, we can export the image itself. This will be a standard image file as a JPEG or a TIFF. Finally, we can also export a copy of the current slide, and this will also be a DS format. Exporting a ROI, a region of interest, is another interesting function of this software. This option allows us to export a DS format, but only from a selected part of the slide. The exported file is still an interactive image, but smaller files are originated, and this will avoid unnecessary storage memory. Click on Export ROI and select an area of interest, which will be highlighted in orange. Double-click on this area to assess the exportation window. Finally, for a fast and easy ROI export, you can just capture an image and a JPEG file will be generated. An easy and effective approach to have a second opinion on a diagnostic is to use the conference tool for remote network sharing. This is a function that will allow third parties to interact with the digital file. Other users can see, edit, and comment the image. Using our free version of the software, which, as I said, is available through our websites. Finally, let me call your attention for the fact that this software allows the encryption of the files. This gives the system all the necessary security to guarantee confidentiality. For the medical community, digital pathology is currently one of the most important resource tools. With the Motic EasyScan, you can have the perfect solution to assess the advantages of using digital slides on a fast, easy, and reliable way. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it gave you some useful information on the new Motic EasyScan system. For further details, please visit www.moticeasyscan.com as well as our YouTube channel and social media platforms. Thanks for your attention.